Good afternoon. So today we're going to study about the next chapter. So mainly it is magnetic induction. So from the magnetic flux change, we can obtain the electromotive force. So that is called the magnetic induction. So, and from the magnetic induction, we can drive one of the Maxwell equation. So that equation will complete the four Maxwell equations, and then from the Maxwell equation, you can drive the electromagnetic wave. So that would be the end of this semester, this subject. Okay, magnetic induction. So induced EMF. So the EMF induced 유도된 기전력 EMF. So the line integral of an induced electric field around the closed path, that is the EMF, and that induced by the magnetic flux change. A time varying electric field give rise to a time varying magnetic field in that region, and the change of the magnetic field generate the induced EMF. 자기장이 시간에 따라 바뀌면 그거에 따라서 기전력이 유도가 되는 현상을 여기서 공부를 합니다. The Maxwell equation formulated by James Clerk Maxwell. So that is called the Maxwell equation. There are four equations. The four Maxwell equations are the basic equation to describe the electromagnetic wave and the related phenomenon. So in this chapter, we can find the four Maxwell equations, and then we can study the electromagnetic wave. So the first thing, let's think about the motional electromotive force. So think about this wire. There is a wire, and in the wire is a metallic thing, so there are many charges inside of the wire. And if we move the wire in this direction, so we are moving the wire in x direction with the velocity of u, and there is magnetic field. Magnetic field is in the minus g direction, and then we can find some force. That force it can be written by this way. So as we already studied the Ampere's force law, so the Ampere force law was what is the Ampere's force law? The Ampere's force law was F equal I and L cross B. We already studied this equation. So this current part and the length part can be changed with this term, because the current is the charge divided by the time, but the time, if the time is applied on the length, then the it will be the charge q, and it will be the velocity u. 우리가 암페어의 힘의 법칙으로부터 이런 공식을 배웠고요. F는 전류, 길이, 그리고 자기장. 여기서 이제 전류와 길이를 전하와 속도로 바꿔 쓸 수 있겠죠. then we can get you may get this equation, or more simply we can write in this way that the Q is the charge and the U is the velocity of the wire, and the magnetic field B. Okay, then it is the force, and also we know the force from the Coulomb's law. The force for the charge, we can consider in this way. It is the charge, and then it must be something like the electric field. 쿨럼의 법칙을 우리가 배웠고 3장에서 그때는 전하가 전기장에 놓여 있을 때 힘을 받는다 그랬고 그때 이 힘이라는 게 전하 곱하기 전기장이었거든요. 그러니까 아 요게 전기장과 비슷한 거구나 이렇게 추측을 할 수 있겠죠. So then we can write in this way the electric field. Can be written by this way. Of course, this electric field is not the electric field we applied externally. 우리가 외부에서 걸어준 전기장이 아니고 유도된 전기장이죠. 이거는 우리가 걸어준 전기장. 그래서 이거는 이제 좀 다른 전기장이긴 하지만 어쨌거나 이게 이제 전기장과 비슷하다 이렇게 생각할 수. So it is the induction of the electromagnetic induction. So this electric field is established by the magnetic field. It is referred to as induced electric field. 유도된 전기장. 우리가 외부에서 걸어준 전하를 가지고 걸어준 전기장이 아니라 자기장에 의해서 유도된 전기장이라는 얘기죠. Okay. So then, now let's calculate the Lorentz force. External force works to move the wire. Yes, in the previous slide, I said there was a wire, and the wire was moving in this direction, so with this velocity. Then now, this wire is connected to the external resistor, then we can calculate how much current would be generated and how much work will be done. So as you already found, the force by the magnetic induction can be written by this way. So this force is called the Lorentz force, and more specifically, the I and the L represents the length from here to here. So L is the length, and the B field. So the B field and the current direction is the perpendicular. And then the force is another direction. So the force is in the AX direction. Force is in AX direction. With minus AX. So this relation can be described by our right hand. So it is called the Fleming's right hand rule. Fleming의 오른손 법칙. 우리가 앞에서 배운 건 Fleming의 왼손 법칙이었고 지금 여기서 나온 건 Fleming의 오른손 법칙이에요. Fleming의 오른손 법칙은 발전기의 원리를 얘기할 때 사용하는 법칙이죠. 여러분들 고등학교 때 배웠으면. Fleming's right-hand rule. So, with this three finger, F, B, I. So, force, magnetic field, and the current. So in this case, the magnetic field is in the minus Y direction, and F, B, F, B is the minus y direction, minus x direction, FBI, and current, current is in this direction, and the force is the upper direction. Am I right? This way. So the force is onto the x direction. Current. Let me check it again. P field. P field. And the B field. B field is in the downward, and the force was applied onto the which is the external force to move the wire. Current and force. It is a little confusing, but the key idea is the external force works to move the wire. So this force is applied to move the wire, and then we can calculate the induced current. When the magnetic field is when the force is on this direction, then we can say the same force is acting not to accelerate the wire. So we can say the external force have the same amount of the force, but the direction is the opposite due to the action reaction law. So we can say the external force is given by this way. Then we can calculate the work by the external force. The work is defined by the force multiplied with the distance of the motion. So F dot dx. So the work can be written by the force and dx, the motion of the length of the motion. So the wire had moved this much. So delta x is the length which was moved. Then we can write the BIL and the dx. The length is equal to the velocity and the time. So velocity and time. That is the length of the wire. So and then the velocity is here, and the current and time, current multiplied with the time is the same as the charge. Charge has moved at the given time, because the charge, current I, is defined by this way, dq dt. So that's why we can write in this way. So the work per unit charge, that is the same dimension of the voltage or potential. So the work per unit charge can be written referred to as EMF, electromotive force. So the motional EMF is defined by dwdq is the same as BLU. So it is the EMF. Motional EMF work per unit charge. So this is not the electron charge. It is the EMF, not the charge. So E is the induced EMF between the two ends of the sliding conductor. So the EMF is has the same dimension of the voltage potential, or the potential have this dimension, work per charge. So the joule per coulomb. So more generally, the motional EMF can be written by this way, with this equation. It is the general equation of the EMF. In the previous slide, the equation was the more simplified case, and the generally we can write in this way. So let me skip the proof. And so Faraday's law of induction. So induced EMF around the closed path is equal to the negative rate of the change of the magnetic flux with respect to time passing through the area enclosed by the area enclosed by the path. So the same configuration of the wire. So wire is here, and they are making the closed loop. So the charge can move in this loop, but this conductor, this wire can move. That means the area of the area of the loop can be changed. 자, 아까도 이제 여러 번 나왔지만 이러한 구조에서는 이제 이거는 폐곡선, 폐회로라고 말할 수 있겠죠. 여기서는 이제 전류가 어떠한 방향으로 기전력이 형성되냐에 따라서 전류가 이렇게 돌거나 아니면 반대로 돌거나 할 수 있는 이런 회로를 이제 폐회로라고 할 수 있어요. 여기서 특별히 이제 요 부분은 요로 움직일 수가 있다. 이쪽 위아래로. 그러면은 이제 그 얘기는 여기서 자기장의 플럭스가 자속이 바뀔 수가 있다 이 말이죠. 자, 그런 상황을 우리가 염두에 두고서 이 자기 유도 관계를 한번 더 고려를 해 보자면, 자, 여기서 지금 요 면적 요 면적이죠. 요 면적이 요 면이 이제 요 와이어가 움직임에 따라서 면적이 더 늘어날 수도 있고 그런 관계. 자, 그래서 the surface the can be written by the length L from here to here is L, and the area can be changed by this much dx, L dx. It is the difference of the area. And this area is on the direction of the AG direction. Surface normal direction is the AG. And then we can calculate the increment of the magnetic flux. 자속의 변화량을 우리가 계산할 수 있어요. 자속 phi. Magnetic flux was defined by this way. It was the magnetic flux. But now, as the wire is moving, as this wire is moving, then we can expect the magnetic flux would be increased. So delta phi, delta phi can be written by this way, the magnetic field, dot product with the delta ds, delta s, the increment of the surface. So the b vector and the surface direction is parallel. So that's why we can write this. Actually, they are opposite direction. So that's why we have the minus sign and the l dx. Yes. And then how about the rate of the flux change? d phi over dt. 시간에 따라서 플럭스가 얼마나 바뀌느냐. 즉, 이것을 시간에 따라 미분해보면, 플럭스의 변화량을 미분해보면, so then you can write in this way. So dt on both sides. So dt on dx, so dx over dt is the same as the velocity u. dx에다가 dt로 나누면, 결국은 속도가 되니까, 이 와이어가 굴러서 움직인 속도와 같게 되겠죠. So that's why we can write in this way. So this amount, the change, the rate of the flux change was the same as the induced EMF we studied. So this much BLU, it was the EMF BLU, and also this one is also the same BLU. So the bottom line is the induced EMF E can be written by the d phi over dt, the change of the flux with the minus sign. 그래서 유도된 기전력은 자속의 변화량, 자속의 시간에 따른 변화량과 같다, 이렇게 놓을 수 있고, with minus sign. 자, 마이너스 사인이 있는 거는 이 방향이 반대 방향이다라는 것을 또 나타내고 있어요. This minus sign. 이 자속의 변화량에 반대하려는 방향이다. 이렇게 생각하세요. So you can understand it this way. If the wire is moving in this direction, that means the flux would be increased, and then the induced current is acting to reduce the change of the flux. 전류가 이렇게 흐르고 있고 자소 이 힘이 작용을 해서 자속이 늘어나게 된다면은 그때 유도되는 전류는 자속이 늘어나는 걸 방해하는 방향으로 전류가 형성된다. 이렇게 생각하면 돼. 왜냐하면 자 여기서 이제 전류가 어느 방향으로 주어졌어요. 유도된 전류가 유도된 전류를 지금 요걸 자 방향을 잘 계산해 보면 이 B 필드가 이쪽으로 형성이 돼서 마치 자속이 증가하는 것을 방해하려는 방향으로 그 전류가 형성이 돼요. 그런 걸 알 수가 있어요. 요 마이너스 부호는 음의 부호는 그러한 의미를 담고 있어요. 그래서 이거를 Faraday's Law of Induction, Faraday의 유도 법칙이라고 부릅니다. So it is an important result. So this relation can be the basis of the generator. 발전기 알죠? 발전기. 코일에 힘을 가해서 자기장이 걸려 있고 코일이 그 안에 감겨 있는데 그 코일에 힘을 가해서 우리가 전기를 발생시킬 수가 있어요. 그것이 이제 발전기죠. 이제 발전기의 기본 원리가 바로 이거를 이제 기반을 한 거예요. So the generator is based on the Faraday's law of induction. 그래서 for the electromagnetic induction, you can consider either this case or this case. So in this case, there is a closed loop, 폐회로가 있고, now we have the permanent magnet. 자, 연구자석이 여기 있어. 자, 만약에 이제 이 연구자석을 이렇게 혹은 반대로 위아래로 왔다 갔다 움직인다면 그에 따라서 이제 자석이 가까워지면 자석이 가까워지면 플럭스가 늘어나고 자석이 멀어지면 플럭스가 줄어들. So this motion will make the change of the flux. So the flux phi is the function of time. It could be changed by the motion of the permanent magnet. Then you can obtain the time derivative of the flux change. Then it is the same as the EMF induced EMF. Or also you can consider in this way. Instead of the permanent magnet, also you can consider the electromagnet or the coil. Here is the coil, and the external battery is connected. Then the current is flow. Current will flow through the coil, then generate the magnetic field. And there is another coil. So each coil have the distance, but if we move if we change the current, if the, so now the current through this coil is changed by the time. So the current I is the function of time. Then again the magnetic flux also will be changed by as a function of time. 자, 여기 전류를 우리가 시간에 따라서 껐다 켰다를 하면 여기 스위치가 있어. 스위치를 가지고 스위치를 껐다 켰다를 반복하면은 전류가 흘렀다가 멈췄다 흘렀다 멈췄다. 전류가 자꾸 시간에 따라 바뀜으로써 자기 장이 시간에 따라 바뀌고 자속이 시간에 따라 바뀌고 자속이 시간에 따라 바뀌면 바로 유도 기전력이 생긴다. 그 말이죠. So in that way, we can generate the induction, induction of the induction EMF can be obtained. So here is the more detailed time frame of the change of the magnetic field and the EMF. So here is a wire and the magnetic. If we have a constant current, then the magnetic field will be generated. So if the current is constant, then the magnetic field is also constant. So B field is a constant, then there is no change of the flux. And the EMF is equal to 0. EMF, no EMF will be generated. But if we increase the current, so at a short time, if we turn on the switch, then the current will be increased. Then the magnetic field also will be increased because the magnetic field is proportional to the current. 자, 자기장은 전류에 비례하기 때문에 스위치를 딱 켜면 전류가 증가할 거예요. 시간에 따라 전류가 증가하면 자기장도 증가해요. 그럼 자기장이 증가하면 자기장의 변화가 생긴 거죠. 그럼 B필드가 증가함으로써 플럭스, 자속도 증가하게 돼요. Now the phi also will be changed. Then you can get the non-zero value of the change of the flux. So then we can have the EMF non-zero value of the EMF. So EMF must be the positive number. The negative number. Okay. So minus something. And if we decrease the current with time, 자 만약에 전류를 우리가 감소시키면 시간에 따라 감소시키면 자기장이 줄어들고 자기장이 줄어들면 이제 이게 양수를 갖게 되는 거예요. 그러면은 EMF가 so the EMF may have the positive number. So this process can be repeated as we turn on and off the switch. 스위치를 껐다 켰다 껐다 켰다 막 반복을 하면 자속이 전류가 이제 시간에 따라 전류가 올라갔다 내려갔다 올라갔다 내려갔다 함에 따라서 기전력이 마이너스 기전력이 발생했다가 플러스 기전력이 발생했다. 기전력이 EMF가 플러스 마이너스 기전력이 그래서 이렇게 플러스 마이너스의 기전력 그걸 우리가 교류라고 부르죠. 교류 alternating charge 예. 교류 신호가 얻어질 수 있어요. 오케이. So the EMF can be the function of time. So the flux magnetic flux phi is not constant. It is the function of time. So particularly the magnetic the flux can be a sinusoidal function. 자 자속이 삼각함수의 형태로 주어지는 경우가 대부분이에요. 자 우리가 이제 그 발전기를 막 돌린다거나 터빈을 돌려가지고 발전기를 돌리면 이게 자속이 증가했다 감소했다 증가했다 감소했다 하는 현상들이 일어나는데 그걸 이제 우리가 이 삼각함수 수학 시간에 배운 삼각함수로 표현할 수 있단 말이에요. So the flux can be the function of the sine function. So then with the constant and the sine omega t. Here the omega is the angular frequency. It is called the angular frequency. 각속도라 그러죠. 각 진동수라고도 하고 각속도라고도 하는데. It can be written by this way. And also we need to know the flux linkage lambda. If the wire is connected with a single turn of the loop, then we cannot get the large amount of the flux. But if we wind with the n-timed loop, 여러 바퀴 감으면 도선을 그러면은 we can get the higher flux. So the magnetic flux linkage lambda is defined by this way. So the flux we can get with a single turn of the wire and multiplied with the number of turns. then this lambda is defined by the n phi. That is called the flux linkage. 도선을 한 번만 감았을 때는 이제 phi만큼의 플럭스를 얻을 수 있다면 도선을 두 바퀴, 세 바퀴, n 바퀴 보통은 뭐 수천 바퀴를 감죠. 그러면은 그거에 비례해서 감은 수 n에 비례해서 플럭스가 증가를 하기 때문에 요거를 magnetic flux linkage라고 불러요. 람다. 그래서 플럭스가 n times increased. Okay, then the EMF also increased by the number of turns. 코일을 감은 횟수 n번 감았으면 n만큼 더 커진다. 유도 기전력이. Or simply we can write the E equal minus d lambda dt. And then then we can use this form onto this equation, and now you know the differentiation on the sine function, the phi m, and if you do the derivative on the sine, then you will have a cosine omega t, and the omega should come to the outside. Okay. And then the other one. What is the phi m? It is the same as the n should be multiplied on both sides, n, and with the minus sign, and the minus sign, then it is the same as minus n the omega, take the omega, and the other part is the same as phi. Phi m. I was a little confused. So we need to take the maximum value. Yeah, 최대값은. So it is the EMF. So the EMF is given by this way. And what is the maximum? 최대값은 요게 1일 때가 최대값이죠. So the maximum value of the EMF is given by the n double omega and the phi m. Yeah, it is the maximum. So maximum value of the EMF is given by this way. 왜냐면은 이게 이제 사인 함수나 코사인 함수 이러니까 최대값은 이게 1일 때가 최대값이 되죠. 1이나 마이너스 1. Okay, so the maximum value of the EMF can be written by this way. And the omega is the same as the 2 pi f. The omega can be written by the frequency. So this relation is the basic relation. So instead of the omega, you can write the 2 pi f. And then, how about the effective value of the induction? Once it had the maximum value, but it could have the lower value and the minus value and the plus value. So if you do have the average, then it will be the zero value. But if you do the root mean square, if you do the square, the value, and then get the average, and take the square root, then you can have this value. I can explain in this way. So what is the RMS? The power is can be written by this way. If the voltage is the cosine function. And the current is also the cosine function, then we may have this much. So VO, IO, VO, and the cosine square. So when we calculate the power or the energy, the sinusoidal function should be should have the square term. Of the function, so then if you want to take the average value of the power, then the cosine square average. So if you do the cosine square or sine square and have the average value, then you will have this value, one over root square root of 2. So because of that, this factor should be multiplied. So this unit is called the RMS value, RMS. Okay? So the RMS unit represents the amount of the power, not the maximum value. So the RMS value, this factor should be multiplied on the maximum value. So then the square root, you can get this result. Square root of 2 pi f and the number of turns and the maximum flux. So square root 2 pi is 4.44 and f. And so the frequency and the number of turns and the maximum flux is the same as the RMS power. So this equation is called the transformer equation. So With this equation, we can estimate how much power we can obtain from the generator. So in this slide, it shows the behavior of the function. The flux phi was the sinusoidal function, like this. So it was the maximum value, but the RMS value should be taken with the square of the cosine function and the average value should be obtained. So the RMS value of the EMF can be written by this way. 자, 이거는 뭐를 의미하냐면, 유도 기전력이 시간에 따라서 삼각함수로 주어질 때 최대값은, 유도 기전력의 최대값은 이렇게 되고, 유도 기전력의 최대값이 아니라 RMS 값은 이렇게 된다. 최대값에 루트 2만큼을 나눠줘야지 RMS 값이 된다. 자, RMS 값은 왜 중요하냐? 이제 파워를 계산할 때는 RMS 값이 파워하고 바로 직결되기 때문에 RMS로 우리가 주로 표현한다. 최대값이 아니고. Okay, so here is an example. So circular conducting loop with a radius 40 centimeter lies in the XY plane and has the resistor with a 20 ohm. And the magnetic flux density. Magnetic flux density is given by this way. And the unit is T, Tesla. 자기장의 단위가 테슬라로 주어졌고, 이럴 때 effective value of the induced current in the loop. So first we need to calculate the flux. So for the flux, the surface element should be obtained. So added had the circular disk symmetry, so we can consider the cylindrical coordinate system. 원통좌표계에서 면적분은 이제 이렇게 할 수 있고. So the magnetic field have the x component, y component, and g component. Yeah. So there are many direction. However, the loop is in XY plane. 자, 루프가 XY 면에 있기 때문에 이렇게 했을 때 지금 요 면상에 있기 때문에 DS surface는 지금 Z 방향이거든. So the surface is normal to G direction. So we don't need to think about these things. We don't need to consider it. We just only need to consider the B field parallel to the surface. Parallel to the surface normal vector. So only we need to consider this term, then the flux can be obtained in this way. So the flux is a function of time. Yes, it is a function of time. The flux is equal to this one. So this part is the same as the area of the disk. 자, 이거는 요 부분은 뭐 아주 쉬운 거죠. 요거는 이 여기에 면적하고 똑같으니까 이게 파이 r 제곱이나 똑같은 거죠. So simply you can obtain this result, but this phi is the function of time. It is a function of time, and then if you wanna get the EMF, it should be differentiated by the time. Then the cosine differentiation will make the sine function, and this coefficient should come again. And then you can get the rate of the flux change, and then you can get the EMF. So then you can get the EMF, and also we studied the transformer equation. So from the transformer equation, the RMS value of the power, RMS value of the EMF can be obtained also. So here this number is the same as omega, angular frequency. 자, 요게 이제 오메가죠. 오메가. And so and the omega is equal to 2 pi f. So the frequency is the 314 divided by 2 pi, then that is the frequency. And what is the number of turns? They didn't mention the number of turns. Then n equal 1, then it's a straightforward. Okay, so as you got the EMF. EMF is the same as the voltage. The voltage or potential or EMF, they have the same dimension, but so the physically the same quantity, but they have the different origin. That's why they have the different name, but physically the same. So the voltage can be described by this way, but of course it's an RMS value, not the maximum value. RMS 값으로 계산한 결과고. So the voltage, and we know the this relation, Ohm's law, V equal IR, from the ohmic law. As we know the voltage, we can find the current. So the current can be obtained by the voltage divided by the resistance. 자, 이거는 이제 EMF를 계산한 거고, EMF가 결과적으로 전 압과 동일한 물리량을 갖죠. 그래서 이제 이게 전압이라고 생각하면 돼요, EMF가. 그리고 이거는 이제 교류니까, 교류는 RMS로 표시한다. RMS로 표시할 때는 아까 맥시멈 값에서 루트 2만큼을 나눠주면 된다. 그렇죠? So, 그리고 전류는 이 공식으로부터 전류는 전압을 저항으로 나누면 또 전류가 얻어지니까 그러면 전류 값도 얻게 되는데 전류 값도 역시 RMS예요 이것도 RMS 교류를 표시할 땐 다 RMS로 표시한다고 생각하면 되겠습니다. 오케이, then the final topic he had left. So the Maxwell equation. So I already explained about this relation. So the flux was given by this way. The flux was the it must be the plus B dot ds. Yeah, it was the flux, and the EMF was given by this way. So it was the EMF from the transformer equation should be equal to minus flux round T round B. ds. Okay, so the magnetic induction can be written by this way. So then this magnetic induction must be equal to the EMF, the definition of the EMF. So this one and this one should be equal. So we can set it as your equation. So the EMF is equal to the change of the flux flux as a function of time. So from this relation the time in time differentiation can be go to the inside. So it is the same expression. So the surface integration and the time differentiation is nothing to do with each other. So the order can be reversed. So then we can put the time derivative inside of the integration. And how about this? This one is equal to, as we know, the Stokes theorem, it is equal to the curl E with the surface integration. And then finally we got this relation. So inside of this integration part should be the same. Yeah. So it must be the equal. So because of that, we got this relation. Curl E is equal to minus round B round T. It is the Maxwell equation, one of the Maxwell equation, the Maxwell equation from the Faraday's law. 자, 파라데이 법칙으로부터 이제 맥스웰 이퀘이션 하나를 우리가 유도해낼 수 있어요. 그래서 이게 이제 그 네 개의 유명한 맥스웰 이퀘이션 중에 하나다. 컬리는 비벡터의 편미분, 시간에 대한 편미분과 같다. 이것이 맥스웰 이퀘이션이고. So we already studied the Faraday's law, and then this equation can be can be derived. And self-inductance. Okay, let me skip the self-inductance. We don't have enough time to study the self-inductance. So let me skip and let me go to the another Maxwell equation. From the Ampere's law, So we studied this equation. It was the Ampere's circular law, not the Ampere's force law. There were two Ampere's law. One is the Ampere's force law, and another one is the Ampere's circular law. It was the Ampere's circular law. But at that time, it was written by this way. Equal I, but now instead of the capital I, it is the lower case of the I. 자, I를 저기 대문자로 안 쓰고 여기 소문자로 썼어요. 왜 소문자로 썼는지 아는 사람? 여러분들 전자공학 배웠으면? 아, 그렇지. 이거는 상수일 때는 대문자로 쓰지만 이제 교류를 다루거나 할 때는 시간에 따라 바뀔 때는 이제 소문자 I로 써요. 그래서 요것이 이제 시간에 따른 함수일 때는 이렇게 소문자 I를 쓴다. Okay, so from this relation, we also studied this one. The I can be, okay. Yeah, we already studied this relation. The I can be written by the integration of the J on the surface. Yeah, we already studied. And also this one by the Stokes theorem, it also can be written by this way. Yeah. So again, we already studied curl H is equal to J. So curl H is equal to J. We already studied. On the other hand, we also studied the continuity equation in chapter 4. 우리 4장에서 연속방 정식을 배운 적이 있어요. 4장에서. 그래서 요 식하고 요 식이 그 요 두 개 식이 따로따로 그 다른 현상을 나타내는 거일 수도 있지만 이 두 개가 한 가지 그 한 동일한 시스템에서 두 개가 같이 나타날 수가 있거든. 그래서 우리가 이 두 개의 식을 하나로 합쳐야 돼요. 그걸 이제 합치는 과정을 이제 맥스웰이 해냈고, 그래서 새로운 방정식을 찾아내는데, 그래서 the divergence J and this term, on this equation, the J should be changed by this way. Okay. So, from the Gauss law, we already studied this equation. Gauss 법칙에서 이제 우리가 익숙하게 이건 많이 봤고, divergence D는 로다. 그리고 양변을 시간에 따라 미분하면, 시간에 대해서 편미분하면 이쪽 양변을 round round t and round round t on both sides, then we can get this relation. 자, 시간에 대한 미분하고 공간에 대한 미분은 전혀 별개이기 때문에 시간이랑 공간은 독립 변수이기 때문에 순서를 바꿔도 되는 거예요. 예, 그래서 다이버전스를 먼저 하고 시간에 대해서 미분을 하나, 시간에 대해서 미분을 하고 다이버전스를 취하나 또, 아무 상관이 없어요. Okay, so we can write in this way. As we know this relation, it was a continuity equation, so it can be written by minus divergence J. Okay, then, this term and this term can be combined onto the left-hand side. So we can transfer this term onto the left-hand, then we can get this relation. Okay, so instead of the divergence J equal J, J equal 0, we got another expression of the current. So this current is called this current is called the displacement current. 요 텀을 요게 이제 숨어 있는 전류였어. 우리가 그 맥스웰 방정식을 유도하는 데 있어서 우리가 간과하면 안 되는 또 다른 전류가 그 d 벡터가 시간에 따라 바뀌는 것이 전류량을 나타내는 건데 그것이 이제 그 쉽게 발견하지 못하는 부분인데 요거를 이제 포함시켜야 제대로 된 표현이라는 거를 이제 맥스웰이 찾아냈고요. So instead of the J plus round D round T should be corrected. 그래서 요 전류를 displacement current라고 부르고 displacement current가 포함된 식으로 다시 바꿨어야 돼. 그래서 curl H equal J, it was the form we already studied, but should be changed by this way. So instead of the J plus displacement current. Yeah. So it is the Maxwell equation, another Maxwell equation. So we studied the Maxwell equation, one of the Maxwell equation from the Faraday law, another Maxwell equation from the displacement current, and the Gauss law. We are familiar with the Gauss law, this law. So it is also the one of the Maxwell equation, and the divergence B. Divergence B represent there is no monopole. If there is the monopole of the magnetic field, it may have the non-zero value, but always in case of the magnetic field, always the divergence B equals zero. So it is another Maxwell equation. So the 1, 2, and 3, 4, so total 4 Maxwell equations already found. So in the next page, here is the Maxwell equation. So this equation came from the Faraday induction, and this equation was the Ampere's circular law plus displacement charge. So displacement current, particularly I said, this term is related with the displacement current, and the divergence D, it is the Gauss law, and this equation represents the no monopole of the magnetic field. So this four equation is the Maxwell equations. So with this four equation, we can finally find the electromagnetic wave equation. So we can combine this equation and this equation. if you look at these two equations, then you may think they are not coupled, but you should remember the E vector epsilon equal D. So the E vector can be changed by D, by multiplying the epsilon, or the B vector, and also we know the H vector is equal to B over mu. So the B also can be replaced by the H vector. Then you may understand this equation is about the relationship between E and B, but also it is a relation of the D and H, and also D and H. So these two equations are coupled together. So if we combine these two equations, then you can find a very interesting equation. So in the next slide. So I said this equation and this equation. So more for simplicity, let's assume there is no free charge and free current. 자, 우주 공간이라고 생각을 하면 우리가 in the space there is no charge and there is no current. So no charge, it's zero, and no current. Okay, but there could be some interesting behavior in the space, open space. Even we don't need to have any medium, but there could be some electromagnetic behavior. So think about this again. Curl E equal minus rounded round T, and curl H is equal to rounded round T. Okay, then if you take the curl on both part, curl and curl on both sides, then you can get this relation. And also you should know another vector identity. Curl and curl, curl curl is equal to the gradient, and the Laplacian. So it is another mathematical result. So I don't want to prove it, but you can accept this result. So the curl is equal to minus Laplacian E and plus curl E. Yeah. So curl. Oh no. What I'm doing now? Sorry. Yeah. The gradient and the gradient divergence. Yeah. So, but we know the divergence D equals zero. So because of that, divergence E also zero. So this term will be disappeared, but Laplacian term will be survived. So Laplacian term will be survived. And how about this? The B vector, I can write in this way. The B vector, what is the relation between the H and the B? B was this way. So it is the curl. Let me change the order. The time derivative come first. Time derivative come first. So I will change it. Round T and curl B, but instead of B, I will write mu H. Yeah, it's okay. Yeah. It's equal to this. And the from this equation, also you can write minus mu is constant. So on the free space, I can put the permeability of the free space. So mu and round t, and the curl. We found the curl H. The curl H is equal to this. So it could be round T D. Yes. So finally, the curl. Finally, Laplacian E is equal to second derivative of the time. Let me do it one more. Yeah, there is another step. Instead of d, we can write epsilon e. So it can be changed by this way: mu zero and epsilon o. And second partial derivative to the e. Okay. Then on both sides we have the minus sign. So finally, we can get this relation. Okay. So finally we can get this relation. So Laplacian E is equal to second derivative of the time of the E, and with the coefficient mu epsilon and mu. So the epsilon and mu was calculated, and surprisingly, this quantity was equal to this much, 1 over c square. Here, the c is the speed of light. 자, 여기서 c가 광속하고 똑같은 거고, 그래서 epsilon mu를 곱했더니 이게 광속의 제곱의 역수와 똑같다는 게 이제 놀랍게도 이게 찾아졌고. 물론 이제 이 광속은 이제 실험적으로 측정을 한 거죠. Experimentally, we can measure the speed of light, and this speed of light is related with the permeability and the permittivity. So, in order to calculate this equation, it is the second order differential equation. 자, 이게 이제 2차 편미분 방정식이고, 2차 편미분 방정식을 계산을 하는 거는 여러분들이 이제 수학 시간에 할 수 있는데, 쉽게 계산을 하려고 하기 위해서는 이제 1차원에서만 생각해 보면은 이걸 1차원에서만 한다고 치면은 이렇게 쓸 수가 있어요. In case of the one dimension, we can write in this way. dz, so d square dz E equal to 1 over c square and round instead of d, we can the round is correct. So E, yeah, the vector should be the vector. So it is a pretty similar to the classical wave equation. 자, 이거 고전역학에서 이제 물리학자들이 고전역학에서 파동 방정식을 연구를 했는데, 요 식이 이제 고전역학에서 많이 계산해 봤던 파동 방정식하고 똑같아요. So it is the wave equation. 이 파동 방정식하고 똑같고, 파동 방정식의 솔루션은 이미 다 계산해 봤단 말이에요, 물리학자들이. 그래서 요게 답이라는 걸 알고 있어요. 요거를 대입하면은 E벡터나 H벡터 요걸 대입하면은 답이 나와버려요. 자, 이걸 한번 대입을 해볼까요? Now let's check. We can insert the equation into this equation. Then as we do the first derivative of the G, here is the G. So the second derivative will make minus I K plus I K and the square. So I K square will come out to the outside as you do the integration. And the same vector E we obtained, and C squared, and the time derivative, time second derivative. 자, 여기서 시간에 대해서 두 번 미분하니까 한 번 미분할 때 I 오메가가 튀어나오고 요거가 second derivative는 두 번 미분하니까 요거 튀어나오고 나머지는 상수, 그러니까 바뀌는 게 없어요. So we can write in this way. So finally, we can get the k square is equal to omega square over c square. Or you can write in this way, omega over k is equal to c. So if you already studied the modern physics or the condensed matter physics, solid state physics, then you are familiar with this equation. It is the phase velocity. 자, 위상 속도라고 부르는 거죠. 오메가 over k is vp. 자, 위상 속도. 그래서 요거를 위상 속도라고 부른다. 혹은 also you study the group velocity is given by d omega dk. It is the group velocity. Anyway, it is the velocity of the wave. So this wave speed, 자, 이 파동방 정식을 만족하는 답은, 만족하는 해는 파동방 정식인데, 이 파동방 정식의 속도가 광속하고 똑같다. So the velocity is equal to speed of light. 자, 그래서 이 파동방 정식을 만족하는 해는 전자기파라고 부르는 거고 속도는 빛의 속도와 똑같다. 그래서 마침내 아 빛이라는 게 바로 요 파동 맥스웰 이퀘이션으로부터 나온 전자기파다구나 하는 거를 이론적으로 알게 된 거예요. So finally, from this Maxwell equation, the scientists found the secret of the light. That is the electromagnetic wave. 그래서 맥스웰 방정식을 계산하고 나온 결과로부터 이제 이것이 파동 방정식 전자기파라고 불렀고 그 전자기파의 속도가 빛의 속도와 똑같다는 걸 알아냄으로써 이제 빛도 전자기파의 일종이구나 하는 걸 알게 됐어요. Okay, so it is the end of this semester, my lecture. So, okay, it's not the end. Next week, Tuesday, we'll have another hour of the lecture. So, at that time, I can give you some summary and some preparation for the exam. I can give you some hint about the exam.